Welcome to the Bearded Banter Podcast, where we'll discuss everything gaming. So sit on back and listen up. Get your headphones ready, we're gonna discuss video games, it's gonna be fun. A win on time for everyone. Wow.
Welcome to Bearded Banter Podcast, the gaming podcast where we talk about fucking games. And also, it was the release of The Last of Us, which came out on Friday. I am the bearded one. With me is Random Richard.
How is it going, everybody? Hey, we're done high school.
Oh, yeah, we are. Fuck. And also with us is that one brony, 258, Mr. Steve Chaos.
Oh, fuck you.
Oh, fuck you, too.
Fuck you and every mall stand that looks like you.
So this week is a little different. The last few weeks we've had topics to talk about. This week we're going back to the free-for-all style.
Yeah.
We're just going to talk about fucking whatever. So Riley, you have been playing The Last of Us.
I have.
Which as of this recording came out on Friday the 14th. It is currently June 19th.
And it's actually made more money than Man of Steel.
Has it?
Yeah.
Oh, damn. Well, I guess we could talk about that, too. But anyway, why don't you talk about The Last of Us for a little bit, since you seem to have a lot to say.
Well, I don't necessarily have a lot to say, because I haven't really had a chance to play it recently due to circumstances that aren't really important.
You fucking bitch.
Shut the fuck up, okay? I can't spend every day of my life gaming.
You fucking bitch.
Oh, fuck off.
Go ahead.
Okay. Now, basically, the game initially starts off in Austin, Texas. You start off as Joel.
Ironic.
What?
Austin, Texas, Joel.
What?
Shane, now is not the time for your rooster toss.
Somehow,
No.
Before
stop,
Riley
stop
did.
Stop the goddamn podcast. Bones, can you replace your brother?
No, I'm sorry. She can.
I'd rather have Bone Podcasts, the Shaved Gearding Network.
Here, let me just fix that real quick. Sorry, you were saying, Riley?
This podcast is going to be a fucking mess, I just know it.
Okay, go ahead about The Last of Us.
You know I can join the call, right?
Oh, fuck!
Oh, for God's sakes, can I talk?
Yes, you can.
Alright, okay. Goddamn.
Alright, fuck. So basically, the game starts off in Austin, Texas. You play as Joel, as a father to his 13-year-old daughter.
Joel Heyman.
And that's when the disease initially starts. You know, first off, it hits Austin. Austin is pretty much just run to death. And spoiler alert.
Oh shit!
It's okay. It's an early game spoiler. And it happens like 5 minutes in the game. His daughter is killed by a government army person.
Then who the fuck is the girl with him in all the trailers?
She's a new character.
Oh.
And all of a sudden, it flashes 20 years later. You're now.
Oh, wow, okay.
I think it's Boston or Philadelphia. I forget which one, but you go all over the United States. And you basically go around killing those fucked up freaks. Now, I'm going to state my opinion on the game so far. And it's a little different from all the other opinions. I'm okay with it. Like, it's okay. It's not the best game I've ever played, and I don't really get all the hype about it.
Yeah, a lot of people have been praising it. Like,
I don't get the hype. Like, I'm playing it, and I'm just like, this is okay.
You know where all the hype comes from? It's fucking Naughty Dog. That's why.
Yeah.
People expect this to be the next Uncharted.
It's not.
And,
like, it's okay, just very repetitive.
Ah, I see. Wasn't...
You're basically doing the same thing.
Well, what about Uncharted? Was that repetitive?
Yes, but Uncharted, like, there was a different little thing each time to it, and that's what made it unique.
Because, see,
Well, not unique, just, you know, different.
Yeah, I really can't say a whole lot, because...
Oh, the Uncharted games are fun.
I haven't played Uncharted, nor do I own a PS3, but from what I've seen of The Last of Us, it looks very similar in terms of, like, gameplay.
It is... However, there's like little tweaks here and there, like the health system. Like, there's actually a health bar, which you don't see in video games anymore.
So are there like health packs and shit?
Yeah,
oh,
and
oh, shit.
How and because basically you hold up and then press R1, and he bandages himself up, and it takes however long, depends on, like...
That reminds me a lot of Far Cry 3.
Yeah, sort of. It depends on, like, how damaged you are. Like, if you're more damaged, it'll take longer to heal. If you're less damaged, it'll take less time to heal.
Yeah, see, the Far Cry 3 did the same thing where,
That's where it's from, I think.
Yeah, if you didn't have a health pack... Or, like, yeah, if you didn't have a health pack on you, you would just, like, bandage yourself up, or it's, like, depending on the way you were injured, it would take a certain amount of time to heal yourself. Like, you've had, like, cuts on your arm from, like, a guy stabbing you, you would, like, bandage it up. Or if you, like, got shot, like, Jason would dig the bullet out of his arm.
Yeah, yeah, something like that.
Brutal as shit. Speaking of which, you haven't played Far Cry yet.
I have not.
You fucking should. You should rent
it. I'll get it eventually. God,
you should rent it this summer, and I shall come over, and we shall play together.
We should.
Because, see, the thing about Far Cry 3 is it's fucking awesome. I would go more in depth to it, but it's just that. It's fucking awesome.
I heard there's turtles.
There are turtles, and you can stab them and skin them and use them for resources.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Oh, it's quite the brutal game.
Oh my God.
So, what else has been going on this week other than the aftermath of E3?
So all in all, Far Cry 3, it's okay. I give it a 6, honestly.
But I thought you never played it.
I thought you didn't play Far Cry 3.
Oh, fuck. Did I say Far Cry 3?
Yeah, you did.
I meant Last of Us.
Okay, Last of Us, 6 out of 10 for Mr. Riley. Don't know what... Well, I can't really say much about it. Since, you know, can't play it.
You will eventually.
Hey
Steve, how you feel about that Last of Us?
I enjoy Uncharted 2.
Uncharted 2 is fucking fun.
Yeah, I heard Uncharted 2 was the best out of the trilogy.
Oh, by far.
Again,
not even
question. Can't really say anything about it. Xbox guy over here.
Hey, Shane, speaking of not talking about the thing we were just talking about.
Hey, yo.
How about that whole Deadpool game coming out soon?
Oh, my God. It comes out on Tuesday.
Comes out on Tuesday. I already pre-ordered, and I got a poster because I live in Canada.
When I actually play that game for the first time. Because, like, this fucking game, one of my most anticipated of the year, because it's fucking High Moon, or the people who brought Transformers into good games. Like, they made Transformers games that didn't suck shit. So I'm really excited to see what they would do with Deadpool. Because, as far as I know, Deadpool hasn't had his own release in terms of video games.
Nope.
Because Deadpool, he's been in, like... Well, most recently, in terms of video games, he was in Marvel vs. Capcom 3... But Deadpool hasn't had his own standalone game. So I'm really interested to see what High Moon would do with Deadpool in a video game environment. And I haven't really seen a whole lot of gameplay, but, you know, I have faith in them because they made good Transformers games. Which, you really haven't heard a lot about that. Speaking of which, yeah. Changing the subject, speaking of High Moon making good Transformers games, something you haven't seen a lot either is good Superman games, which ties back into Man of Steel that just came out last week.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like, the last substantial Superman game I remember coming out was Superman Returns.
Superman 64.
And that was not that good, and I've played it, and it's not that good. Yeah.
Huh. I played the demo, and, like...
Okay.
Okay, go ahead. Sorry.
Okay. Now, even though this technically doesn't count as a Superman game, you can play as Superman and Lego Batman 2, and that's honestly a lot of fun.
Yeah, I've heard you say a lot of good things about Lego Batman 2.
I really like that game.
Oh, what the fuck? What was the last Lego game I played? Oh, shit. I honestly think it was like Lego Indiana Jones, like 4 years ago.
That one's fun.
I don't know. Lego games have become oversaturated at this point.
It's the same thing.
They have to make a fucking Lego game for every goddamn license they can.
Oh, man. I'd like to see Lego Jurassic Park.
Oh, God. You know they'll probably get to that eventually.
Ooh.
Fucking shit.
Ooh. What movie series would you like to see done as a Lego game?
Huh. Steve?
What?
Answer the question.
You first.
Oh, I have to think about that. I have to think about, like, one of my favorite movie series.
It can only be movies or, like, anything?
Anything, like... Victor Hugo novel.
Well, I mean, let me just look up Victor Hugo real quick.
He did Hunchback of Notre Dame and Les Miserables.
Victor Hugo. Wikipedia.
I was just using him as an example.
Still fucking thinking.
Oh, actually, while we're on the topic of Victor Hugo, who here has seen the original Disney Hunchback of Notre Dame?
I have.
Okay. Does Quasimodo jumping everywhere, doesn't that seem like, you know, a perfect Assassin's Creed game?
Not that I like Assassin's Creed, but...
I've never played any Assassin's Creed.
Really?
What? You guys have...
Whoa, Steve, you have not played a single Assassin's Creed.
Not even once.
Wow, that's surprising. I'm not much better. I've only played... I know what you're going to say. I've only played the first one, and...
This one's fucking garbage.
I do not like it.
The second one is really, really good.
See, I was going to say, I would try the second one, because I've heard out of all of them, that is supposed to be the best.
Better than the third one.
And since this summer, it's coming free to Xbox Live users, I'm probably going to play it this summer.
Okay, Steve, what the fuck did you just post?
Oh, he posted something.
Legend.
In Lego.
Just pick a random book.
It did look like the best one. The Legends of...
The Shining.
The Legend of...
No, the best
Lego,
book he did...
Lego The Shining.
Ooh, that'd actually be kind of cool.
Here's Johnny.
Here's Lego.
No, fuck you.
You know what?
Going back to the topic about the Lego games,
you know what a good Lego game is that no one remembers?
Which one?
Lego Island.
Yes! Yes!
I am actually not familiar with that.
Welcome to Lego Island.
That game was awesome. I actually got that cereal box.
It's fucking 97. That's why I don't know it. Okay. You know what I just thought of? Lego Roller Coaster Tycoon.
Okay.
I don't know why. I just thought of that.
There's Roller Coaster Tycoon on the 3DS.
Is there?
Steve, did you just blow out your fucking mic?
No, that was Riley.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, wait, sorry.
There's a 3DS Roller Coaster Tycoon?
Yeah, but apparently it sucks.
Oh, yeah. The only one that are good are 1 and 2. 3 is shitty.
Usually the third game in a trilogy is usually shit.
Yeah. Not always, but, you know...
Not always, but a majority of the time.
Modern Warfare.
It's like, threequels don't get a whole lot of praise because they're usually not good.
Rare exception, Toy Story 3.
Rare exception, Toy Story 3.
What about, Banjo 3?
Oh, you mean Nuts and Bolts? Hey, Bones, why don't you tell us what you think about Nuts and Bolts?
Nuts and Bolts, the second one?
I hope everyone heard that.
Bones, I love you.
Bones, we should talk.
We should talk. But anyway, now that we're on the subject of that shit, I know, Riley, you've played both of the original Banjo games, correct?
I've only played the first one.
You have not played Tui.
No, I told you that.
Oh, wow.
You need to play.
Yeah, you really do. Emulate that shit. Steve, right. What about you?
What's a banjo?
Okay.
I played an N64 game with Mac controls. It sucks.
Yeah, but you said, actually...
But you said...
If you find the right software, you can just plug your PS3 controller right into your computer and it'll work.
Oh, fuck, are you serious?
Yeah, what you do is, because your charger cable is a USB, you just plug it into your computer, and then using the right software, it'll calibrate your controller with the computer. And you can use that.
Yeah, same thing if you have a wired Xbox.
Yeah, controller. And if you have a wired Xbox controller, it'll work right away. I don't, and then I had to find an adapter that doesn't work. It doesn't work, right? Nope. No, but doesn't work for shit.
Would this work on Minecraft?
Possibly. You would have to find software to make it work.
Oh, fuck that.
So look up PS3 PC controller software. You might find something.
I'm looking up Mac. But no,
anywho, so Riley, I was going to ask you which of the Banjo games you thought was the best, but you've only played the first one, so never mind.
Obviously, that was a really good game, and I spent a lot of time on that as a kid.
Yeah, but speaking of Banjo, let's talk about Rare for a little bit, because they just announced at E3 that they're bringing back Killer Instinct. Not the series I would have wanted to see come back, but you know, it's a thing.
They should just re-fucking boot Banjo-Kazooie.
Yeah, but seeing as how it's the modern Rare, we probably wouldn't want to get... We wouldn't want to get our hopes up. They'd probably make fucking Nuts and Bolts the second one.
Nuts and Bolts 2, more vehicles, no jumping! Oh god, no.
Oh god, please, shut up.
Nuts and Bolts, the second one, confirmed Image.
Confirmed it. I've already put it in the goddamn podcast. I've not put it back up.
Why not?
That's why.
But Shane...
Steve?
But Shane.
I love you.
Oh, thank you.
I want you to die.
That's not nice.
Oh, it's very nice.
You're very bipolar, Shane.
How do you know?
Because you just said, I love you, and then you wanted to kill me.
I want to
you. That's just Shane.
I'm going to go and... I'm not going anywhere. I lied.
Yeah, you're not going anywhere. Don't fool us.
I was going to go record, but I'm still doing this media thing, so...
Oh, God! Asshole!
Anyway.
That wasn't very nice.
Anyway.
Okay, no, fuck this. I'm going to go try out the PS3 controller thing. I'm looking up how to do it right now. I'm going to try it.
You fucking try it. But,
I swear to God, if this works, I will do something cool.
I'm going to play Roller Coaster Tycoon.
Hey, I will jack off.
Hey, one fucking game that I just thought of because I saw videos of it on my YouTube subscriber feed, Fallout 3. I know you fucking played it, Riley.
Yep, I have it.
Yes, I have it too.
Oh, who's that?
Steve, have you played Fallout 3? Not Far Cry 3.
I played New Vegas for literally 10 minutes and then I got bored, so...
New Vegas sucks. New Vegas is horrible.
Yeah, that's what I've heard. If you're going to play any of the modern Fallout games, play my Fallout 3.
Yeah.
But it's just like, since they're old now, you can find them, like, super cheap.
Yeah, I bought my New Vegas at Shoppers Drug Mart for $15.
What? Seriously?
Yeah.
It was at Shoppers.
Wow.
Yeah, it was in, like, the Xbox bin next to Red Dead Redemption Game of the Year Edition.
That's the fucking first time I've ever heard someone say, hey, I bought a video game from Shoppers.
Okay, we should probably address what Shoppers is. It's the Canadian version of Walgreens.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't fucking know
Shoppers,
that.
Shoppers, Walgreens are basically identical.
Well, which American people do you know who watch this show?
No one.
I know a couple.
I'm going to go and play Lego Star Wars 2.
Okay. Go ahead. That game is fun.
Yeah, but like I said before, these new Fallout games, since they're older, you can get them for fucking cheap as hell. Like, I know because I got it from Best Buy. At Best Buy, you can get Fallout 3, the Game of the Year Edition, with all of the DLC for only $20.
Nice.
Which is a fucking steal. And then also, you can get the New Vegas Ultimate Edition, which is New Vegas with all of its DLC, for $20 too. So, like, if you haven't played these games, you should probably get them. Because Bethesda... Hey, Bones, let us know what you think about Bethesda.
Okay, Shane, come on.
That was Bones.
I'm already hard of hearing. Don't make it worse.
I should probably make it worse.
Oh, Steve. God, Steve, don't do yours.
But I like mine.
Do it!
Okay, do it.
No, I won't do it.
Okay, do it.
Come on, Steve.
No, Riley doesn't want it. We're recording.
Fucking Bones is demanding it. You have to...
Shane, this is a very compromisable business that we may or may not have here.
Steve.
Bones, can you just, like, get a mic and join us?
I told you to fucking pull up a chair. You're a fucking little bitch. Anyway, we were saying...
Oh, that's cute.
No, it's not.
Instead of Equestria Daily, it's the last of Equestria Daily.
Oh, god damn it. Anyway,
Hosted.
Oh, you're sending me this shit?
Yes, I am.
No, thanks. I'll look at it later. But anyway, what was I talking about? I was talking about Fallout.
No, you weren't. You're talking about stop.
Steve, what I know what I was talking about.
Yes.
But, speaking of Bethesda, how about that Elder Scrolls Online coming to consoles? Ooh. Which is, you really don't see a whole lot of MMOs on consoles, mainly because it's developed for PC.
Oh, they're made for those things, man.
It's like massive multiplayer online components, hundreds of people playing at once. It's like, you know, those games started on the PC, and now it seems like they're transferring to consoles, starting with Elder Scrolls Online. Because really, think about it. Before Elder Scrolls Online, what major MMOs have you heard about on console?
That's annoying.
Hold on.
You're actually thinking about this, I can tell.
MMORPG.
Yes.
DC Universe for PS3.
Oh, shit! That exists!
Yep.
Wow, I actually forgot about that game. Which is weird, because for a long time, like for a long stretch of time, I heard all the shit about that game. Where it had frequent updates, like, hey guys, the one I remember is when they announced that Green Lantern, like the Green Lantern pack was coming to DC Online. That was the last I heard of that.
Yeah.
Fucking DC.
Riley, do you play that daily on your PS3?
I do not.
Oh, you're missing out. Actually, I wouldn't know. I've never played it.
Kind of want to play PlayStation All-Stars right now, but I'm recording.
Hey, PlayStation All-Stars, that's a game.
It is a game, and I fucking love it.
Oh, okay, even though it's just Smash Bros. On Sony.
Hey. Save that for another episode.
Which fucking doesn't make sense to me. Because it's very clear that PlayStation All-Stars is, I wouldn't exactly say clone, but it's very similar to Super Smash Bros., except for the actual fighting mechanics, where in Smash Bros., you have, like, damage percentage, where over time, the more damage you'll inflict on your opponents, the higher their damage percentage will go, which will make them easier to knock out of the arena. Fucking PlayStation All-Stars, hey, stop scratching the microphone, whoever's doing that.
Oh, sorry, that's me.
But, in PlayStation All-Stars, the only way you can score points is not through how much damage you inflict on your opponents, is the only way you can score points is by hitting a finisher on your opponents.
Yeah.
Which, I don't know, that just seems like a weird fighting system to me.
Shane, you should come over and we can play together.
Oh, I will. Stop! Stop! Stop!
What?
This summer. Okay.
Move!
This summer, we'll fucking do co-op Let's Play.
Of iNinja?
You already did that.
You whore.
Thank you. So, Riley!
What's up?
How's that PS3 PC controller going?
It ain't working.
Okay, fuck it.
Fuck this.
Well, okay. Well, I tried.
Well, you tried and failed.
Hey, shut up.
Shane, how long is this going on for?
I don't fucking know.
Okay. I mean, I guess it's okay.
I'm gonna guess it's gonna go on for the rest of our lives.
Well,
I hope you like sitting here talking about nothing for 5 hours.
I don't know if I have that kind of time, Shane. I mean, I got a wife and kids to look after.
All right.
Oh, Steve, you're married?
My daughter, Sarah, just died from an army man, so... And I heard there's a virus going around.
Something tells me you've been playing...
I should probably get to Boston and meet up with Tess.
Well, if you put it like that, I mean, we could get some fucking Vaseline for her.
Whoa!
I tried putting a Band-Aid on her open wound, but that didn't work.
Did you notice at first that her open wound was her rib cage split open?
Well, I mean, Uncle Tommy, like, he thought he had the situation handled, but, you know, clearly he didn't.
I mean, I guess he didn't fucking know what he was doing.
Also, I have not even played Last of Us.
Yeah, me neither.
I don't know
what the fuck I'm talking about.
I'm gonna play as Toro, because he's a cat.
He is a cat.
I like cats.
Well, then you should be a PlayStation All-Stars. We could play together, have a gay old time.
He doesn't play online.
You fucking penis.
You know what? I'm eventually just gonna do it. You know, fuck what my brother says. He's a dick.
Yeah, for some reason, well, it is his brother's PS3. For some reason, his brother doesn't want to connect it to the internet.
Shane, you know my brother. He's a pussy.
I don't want to say that.
He's a pussy, man. Because, okay, you know what he does? He's like, Riley, they're fucking psychopaths online. I don't want you to get involved with them. I'm like, Ryan, seriously?
Oh, my God.
My brother's very protective.
Oh, my God.
And I don't care if you just heard it.
Everything you fucking tell me about him is just worse and worse.
I don't give a
fuck. Oh, my God.
What?
He does know that it's anonymous IDs, right?
Yeah.
And he does know you don't have to talk to people online if you don't want to.
I don't even have a mic.
And he does know...
I like listening
that
to people
you can
yelling.
Just play games for fun with people that you'll never meet or never know who they really are for 5 minutes, and then you'll be back to your old regular life. Oh my God, I want to stab him.
Tell me about it!
Riley, would you mind if I sprinted to your house right now and shanked your brother?
If you want to, go ahead, but, like, you know, I ain't gonna stop you.
I mean, if you put it like that, I mean, I'll keep the door unlocked for you.
Yeah, just lock it on the way out. I'll give you a key.
Okay.
Oh God, he's killing me.
Speaking of those video games, you know that one video game when you can run into people's houses and shank them?
You mean every game nowadays?
Grand Theft Auto?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, which reminds me that GTA 5 comes out in a couple months.
It was supposed to already be out by now.
Well, you know. You know what? It brings me to this topic about game delays, which I don't care if developers delay their games. The sign a game being delayed is just a sign that the developer wants to make it as good as it possibly can be, which I don't have any problem with. I would rather them take as much time as they need to actually release a finished game rather than them just push it out to store shelves and have it be a glitchy piece of shit.
Like the first Sonic the Hedgehog 06.
Hey,
don't get me started on this again.
Oh, Steve, let's get you started on that.
I'm busy playing PlayStation All-Stars.
So how about that Sonic 06?
This is a good game.
Have you noticed we mentioned this game a lot
in
podcasts?
Kind of infamous.
Hey!
Which...
Are we done?
Citizen Kane of shitty recent video games.
Like, holy shit, dude. It's already been fucking almost 7 years since Sonic 06 came out.
Are we done here?
Wow, no, we're not at all.
Can I just, like, leave?
No.
How long are we fucking here?
You're never allowed to leave.
I mean, I have free will.
No way in. No way out. No way in. No way out.
It's something, like, American like myself has, so.
Steve, you lied to us.
I mean... You never asked, so.
Well, I mean, you are American, so I guess it makes sense.
Ah! You're American?
Yeah.
Really?
I was also born from a volcano.
He was born.
Yeah, me too.
He was born Giovanni Cass from the most fiery volcano found in Rio de Janeiro.
It's not even a real place.
Oh, it so is.
It's not.
So anyway, Let's talk about one more gaming-related topic before we wrap things up here. Riley, go!
Is this like a mandatory thing?
Steve, join in on this. No, we'll... Hold on, we'll do that later. Anyway. Riley, any topic you can think of?
What do you guys think about all the video games coming out these days and how they're all kind of basically very easy?
Oh, you mean how they're all fucking first-person shooters?
Not that necessarily, but, like, what do you think of the fact that most video games these days are all just, like, batshit easy and you can do in, like, three hours?
How games have been catered more for the casual audience and have been nerfed in terms of difficulty?
Yeah.
See, I like a challenge... In a game,
God.
I'm kind of 50-50 on it.
Because
half of me likes, like, a decent challenge in a game where I actually have to work towards an ultimate goal. And, like, it doesn't just hand me everything. It actually makes me work for
not like, you know, those parents who give their kids awards for crossing the street.
Yeah.
Okay.
But then the other half of me just wants to sit down and play a fucking game for fun, and if it's hard as shit and I can't get through it, there's no fun in that. So
it's like those two sides are constantly at war in your head.
Yeah, I'm kind of on both sides of the argument. Steve, what do you think about it?
I think you're gonna fucking die soon, but I got this. I'm not even listening to anything.
Well, Steve,
I heard something about video games sucking nowadays.
I fucking love you.
Okay.
You know what? Give me a hug.
I'm not hugging my mic, Shane.
I just hugged my mic.
I can tell.
Okay, I'll put that down so the static stops. But Riley, since you brought the topic up, what do you think?
Games are definitely made too easy these days. Like, remember back in the old days, games like Banjo-Kazooie, games like Mario 64 that were fucking hard as hell?
Well,
no.
See, I get what you're saying about Mario 64, because in certain places that was difficult as shit. I don't think the original Banjo-Kazooie was all that difficult. Sure.
Okay. You remember one of the...
It was quite a challenge, but the overall game, I don't think was like a constant challenge.
Remember that one of the Jinjos and remember one of the Jiggies in Rusty Bucket Bay?
I fucking hated Rusty Bucket Bay.
Oh, fuck.
Don't get me started on
that place. That place sucks, man.
It's got a funny name.
It's like Grunty Industries in Banjo-Tooie. Which,
yeah.
I know you... Hold on. Bones, so you've told me in the past that one of your favorite worlds in Banjo-Tooie was indeed Grunty Industries, which many people think that it was the worst level in Banjo-Tooie, and that it was a piece of shit. What do you feel about this?
It was a great level. The fuck is wrong?
Why do you think it's a great level?
Oh, I don't know. I haven't played in a while.
You can go fuck yourself with a rusty spork.
Cloud Cuckoo Land or Cuckoo Land or whatever the fuck it was called.
Ironically, that was my favorite level in Banjo-Tooie.
I hate that level.
But it's so whimsical. Guys, if you haven't... It was whimsical. If you haven't seen any footage of Cloud Cuckoo Land from Banjo-Tooie, look up some gameplay footage. Because
that... It's fucking stupid.
Don't listen to her. It's actually a really fucking great level. It is one of the most whimsical, imaginative worlds I've ever seen in the video game.
I like Bomb on Battlefield.
Oh, you mean the first level in Mario 64 that everyone fucking knows?
I mean, there's also Jolly Roger Bay. That song's kind of magical.
That's the one I fucking hate.
Yeah.
Lagoon.
Jolly Roger's Lagoon is a piece of shit. Jolly Roger's Lagoon and, to me, Grunty Industries are the two worst levels in Banjo-Tooie. Riley has absolutely no idea what I'm talking about.
I'm talking about Jolly Roger Bay, which is also from Super Mario 69.
That's hot. Anyway, shit. What was I gonna fucking... Well, Riley mentioned that games these days are too easy.
Oh, he didn't.
Yeah, he did.
I didn't.
Riley, what was your argument?
No, Steve was right. I never said anything.
Well... Well,
just kidding. Yeah, games are too easy these days and geared towards casual gamers.
Yeah, but I personally think that games are trying too hard to cater to Call of Duty fans these days, because like there are so many goddamn first-person shooters nowadays. It's fucking ridiculous, and they're all trying to rip off COD because COD is basically the industry at this point, and everyone knows that so many people play COD. That if they want anyone to pay attention to their game, they have to try and rip COD off.
Yeah, especially that Last of Us game.
Fuck no, just fuck you. Just, if you have an idea...
Blame it on the stupidity of the gaming audience.
If you have an idea for a game, and you think that would only work in a first-person shooter, that's completely fine. But if you're going to go that route, don't try and be just another Call of Duty. Try and actually stand out.
Which is tough to do, but just don't... I don't want more shovelware out there.
BioShock Infinite. That's all I'm going to say.
The game you think that is art?
Fucking, it's so beautiful.
It's meh.
Here, I'm going to pass it over to Bones, because I know she loves fucking BioShock Infinite.
It's awesome. That's all I have to say. I cried, like, the whole last hour I played it. It's a mess.
Yeah, the fucking final stretch is just so good. I know you're indifferent to it, Steve.
I am. I still enjoy Bioshock 1 way better.
Well,
I still need to play that.
Well, that's your opinion. And
Bones, if you play Bioshock 1 first, you would understand.
I didn't. I never got past
the fucking Bones. Bones, we're going to do a co-op Let's Play of Bioshock.
We should.
Anyway.
New confirmed game by Wii.
Anyway, I guess that'll wrap up this edition of Bearded Banter.
Oh, wow.
Riley, Steve, thanks for being a part of it, as always.
So, basically, thanks for being dragged into my shitty podcast.
Oh, yes.
It was always good to do a podcast. They're fun.
Yeah. It's just fun to sit down for like half an hour and discuss games and other...
Just ruins my day. Oh, my friend invited me to a party.
So, right. Let's end the podcast with everyone stating the game that they're currently playing and just a quick little opinion on it. Riley, we'll start with you.
Okay, right now I'm playing The Last of Us, and it's not... I don't think it's worth all the hype.
You just think it's average.
Yeah.
Okay. Steve, what have you been playing?
I'm playing PSASBR right now.
PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale?
Yes. Also, if you think you can take down a 999 level Toro, fight me, brah. And then I'm also, Mitchell just texted me saying I should play Marvel vs. Capcom with him. Which, again, if we all know, you should go to your local Kentucky Fried Chicken and pick up a copy of Marvel vs. Capcom.
Good, Steve. Good.
Oh, bye-bye, everybody.
Oh, we're not... So,
no, that's the outro.
No, it's not.
I want to see the little bearded...
I'm sorry, Steve. I had to shut you up.
Whoa.
I had to shut you up, Steve. I'm sorry. That wasn't the outro.
Why do you always keep kicking me?
Because I love you.
But, did I do something wrong?
The game...
Are we still recording?
Yes. The game I have been playing is a little game called Sleeping Dogs. You think everything is meh. Fucking
no,
Sleeping Dogs.
I said heh. Because it sounds funny.
Okay.
It sounds like
Sleeping Dogs is actually a really good game. I actually heard a lot about it because it came out last year. I heard a lot about it, but I had never actually played it. And then I started playing it, and it's like, it's an open world game. It's an open world third person action game set in Hong Kong. And the gameplay is like a mix between GTA and Saints Row, with combat from like the Batman Arkham games.
Huh.
So you hear about that? Arkham Origins.
Like, it takes elements from all these awesome games and it just puts it into a Hong Kong setting, and it actually works surprisingly well. It's like it's really fluid in terms of gameplay. So that's what I've been playing. I think it's fucking great. And probably after I'm done recording this, I'm gonna go and play some more of it because I'd say I'm halfway through.
What about Bones?
Hey Bones, what have you been playing lately?
Tomb Raider. It's awesome. I love it.
Damn titties.
Thank you, Bones.
And that will wrap up this edition of the Bearded Banter Podcast. Thank you very much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. I am the Bearded One. With me is Random Richard and that one Brony258, Mr. Stephen Cass. We will bid you adieu. Come on, guys. Say it with me.
No.
Adieu.
Fuck you.